Letter Bell 11 is due out next week, March 12th, 2024, which is a week from this recording. And one of the things that's getting an update, it's kind of minor, but it's still getting an update, is the Letter Bell welcome page. And if you're brand new to Letter Bell, what this is when you install a new app and you go visit in the browser, the welcome page is just kind of a generic little placeholder. It shows, some different links, got the logo, and I think it even tells you what version you're using, other things like that. So in this video, I want to go through and demo and show you the history of the welcome page, going all the way back to Letter Bell 4.2. So with that, let's just jump in and start with Letter Bell 4.2, and then go from there all the way up to the latest Letter Bell 11 one. So Letter Bell 4.2 had a very minimal homepage. It had the logo at the time, and it was actually Base64 encoded. That way, they didn't have to ship any image files, down to your website, basically. And you could just, sort of delete it. You didn't have to worry about having this file hanging around. So that was sort of the original idea behind that. But so it had the Base64 encoded logo at the time, and then it just said, "You have arrived." It was very minimal, very basic, very simple. From here, Letter Bell 5 went even more minimal. It just had Letter Bell 5, and then it showed an inspiring quote. And that uses the Inspire facade, which, if you run PHP Artisan Inspire, it will throw out a random quote, a random inspiring quote. So it used that under the hood, and, each time you refresh, it would just have a brand new little quote there. So if you ever want the history of why we have the inspiring thing, it leads back to that. From there, Level 5.5 went a little darker with the text, but then removed the inspiring text and went to links. So it had a link to the documentation, Lettercast, Lettervel News. We love that. Thank you. And Forge and GitHub. So again, still minimal, still basic. Letter Bell 8, that's when they introduced a brand new branding. They got a new logo, got a new word mark. So the Letter Bell 8 welcome page, it introduces that, and then it moved all the links to basically like a little section and then little cards within that section. Also in the bottom right corner, it then started showing you your Letter Bell version that you have installed. Another neat thing with Letter Bell 8 is it added dark mode. And I know, I probably at the time people were like, well, why does it need light and dark mode? It's literally just a welcome page that probably you're not really going to use that much. And to me, it just shows you the level of detail that the Letter Bell team puts into all these releases. Just like I said, it's just minor, but a lot of work went into doing that, and it puts your mind that, hey, this team cares, and I'm going to enjoy working with this framework. In my opinion, that's what I like so much about Letter Bell and just the minor little details that are taken care of for you. And now for Letter Bell 10, they kept the light and dark mode, but instead of having the logo with the word mark, they just removed the word Letter Bell from the logo, centered it, and moved all the different links into actually separate cards. Kept the version in the bottom, but everything else basically stayed the same. And that brings us to Letter Bell 11, which to me, it has this, it's improved a lot. It's got this gorgeous and inviting screen. It's got this cool little red fade coming off the corner. It's definitely well designed. It's got sort of the same layout as the previous version. It's just added a little bit more background flair, added a sort of a dummy screenshot to it, but kept all the same links, kept all the same features. But to me, this is probably the best one yet. I love just the minor details and how much it pops and it makes you appreciate the design. So that is the history of the Letter Bell welcome page. I'd be curious, which one's your favorite? What can they do in the future to make this page even better for when you start a brand new app? You know, like and subscribe, and you know, leave a comment below. Let us know. We love to interact and engage with everybody. So thanks for watching, and enjoy the Laravel 11 update.